date for our video? Oh my gosh, I completely forgot. So you're saying that the kids are already here? Hey guys!
Hi everyone, I'm Mrs. Stewart.
And I'm Miss B. Hi, Miss Stewart.
Hey, Miss B, nice outfit. Today we're going to teach you about two artists. The first is named Pablo Picasso, and he was a painter.
The second artist is named Igor Stravinsky, and he was a musician. Both artists were part of the avant-garde movement, which focused on creating art that was new and different than anyone had ever seen or heard before.
These two artists were great friends, and they supported each other. Picasso even designed some strange and wild costumes for some of Stravinsky's ballets.
Those two sure did get into a lot of trouble together.
They sure did. Here are some of Pablo Picasso's self-portrait paintings.
Here is a portrait of Igor Stravinsky, drawn by Pablo Picasso.
Here are some quick facts about Pablo Picasso. He was born in Spain in 1881. Pablo Picasso was taught how to paint by his father. Pablo's dad was an artist and a musician. Eventually, Pablo's dad decided to give up painting altogether because he said that he would never be as great of an artist as Pablo is. Pablo Picasso could paint in any style, even super realistically. But he decided he wanted to come up with his own style, and he called it Cubism. In the Cubism style, everything is made up using geometric shapes, like squares and rectangles and circles. There are also a lot of straight lines and blocks of color. Cubism does not look realistic at all. Check out these artworks by Pablo Picasso. I want you to pay attention to the lines and the shapes that you see in the artwork. You can definitely tell from Pablo Picasso's artwork that he really loved music. Speaking of music, let's get back to Ms. B.
Here are some quick facts about Igor Stravinsky. He was born in Russia in 1882, only 1 year after Pablo Picasso. Stravinsky's parents were both musicians, and they taught him to play the piano. One of the most famous pieces of music that Stravinsky ever wrote is called The Rite of Spring. And it uses musical instruments and sounds to create shapes and lines, like an artist does in their paintings. Do you hear the sharp, pointy sounds in this section? How about the long lines in this bassoon solo? The Rite of Spring was different than any ballet music that had ever been written before. And when it was first performed, people got so upset that they actually rioted outside of the ballet theater.
Wow, Miss B, that was so cool. I could definitely hear all of those sounds in the music. A lot of people did not like Pablo Picasso's new style of painting.
And a lot of people did not like Stravinsky's new style of music.
Picasso's artwork looked jumbled and even crazy.
And Stravinsky's music sounded jumbled and crazy.
But today, Pablo Picasso and Igor Stravinsky are two of the most famous artists on Earth.
And this proves you should always do what you love and be yourself.
Got that right, Miss B. Thanks for coming to learn with us today. I had a really great time learning about a famous musician. Now that that's done, let's do some art. Here's my examples of the artwork that we're going to be making today. Let's get started. So here's the artwork that we're going to be making today, and we're going to borrow a lot of ideas from Pablo Picasso's cubism style, such as lots of geometric shapes, like rectangles and triangles. We're also going to add a lot of straight lines. He kept his lines super straight. He didn't do a whole lot of wavy lines. And then also lots of blocks of color. I also want you to notice that this instrument is a violin, which were commonly found in Stravinsky's music. So we're going to do a violin because we are representing the musician Stravinsky in our artwork as well. Here's what you'll need for this drawing. A pencil. And if your pencil does not have an eraser, then make sure that you have an eraser, just in case you mess up.
You will also need a black marker or a black pen to trace it with. And if you don't have a black pen, a blue pen will be fine too. And then finally, you're going to need something to color it with, like crayons or colored pencils. And for this drawing, I actually think that markers would work really well since we're keeping everything really simple with lots of straight lines. So markers will be good to color this as well. And really quick before we get started, I want to talk to you guys a little bit about paper. So some of you have messaged me and said that you don't have plain white paper at your house. That's okay. You can use any kind of paper. You could use colored construction paper. You could use lined paper. You could use paper that's in an old notebook that you didn't use up. Or you could use a notepad that you have laying around. Or you could use the back of something that you messed up on, or the back of a letter that came in the mail to your parents. Any type of paper that you have laying around will be perfectly fine for any of our projects that we're going to do. All right, so this is an artwork that is tall and skinny, so make sure that you have your paper tall and skinny. And the first thing that we're gonna do is we're actually gonna start by drawing a straight line right down the middle of our paper, and that is going to divide our artwork up into two different sections. One side we're going to draw our violin a little bit more realistically, and on the other side we're going to get much more abstract and cubistic with the violin. All right, so we're going to start on the left side of our picture, and the first thing that we're going to draw is the bout of our violin. So this is a picture of a violin. And we are drawing a violin in honor of the musician Igor Stravinsky that we learned about. He loved to use violins in his music. So first we're going to draw the body of the violin, or it's also called the bout. So starting in the middle of your line right here, we're going to do two bumps. A bump and a bump. And that is the body or the bout of our violin. Next, we're going to add the neck, and we're just going to do so by adding a rectangle. So I'm going to go out a little bit and down till it connects with my violin, with the body of my violin, and now we have our neck right here. All right, we're going to add the pegs now, which are those little knobs that you use to tune the instrument, and we are actually going to simplify them and just make them two rectangles, and I'm going to make one of mine a little bit longer and bigger than the other, just so it kind of looks more like Pablo Picasso's cubism style. Let's add some details to the bout of our violin. First, we're going to add a big oval right here, and that is actually where the musician rests their chin while they play their violin. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to add three lines, and those are going to be the strings, but I'm going to do mine in kind of an abstract way. And this is kind of a way that Pablo Picasso did things often, was to take a part of the thing he was drawing and kind of angle it a little bit differently than it actually is. So I'm going to draw three lines, and they are just going to be kind of going diagonally this way. I'm not going to add any lines to my neck just because I want it to look more unrealistic and cubistic, but if you want to add those extra lines to the neck of your violin, you may do that. Next, we're going to draw the bow of our violin, and that is that long stick that the violinist uses to kind of stroke the strings of the violin, and that's how the noise is made. So we're going to keep it really simple. We're just going to do a very long, skinny rectangle for our bow. I made mine kind of crooked. And then we're going to add two details. We're going to add a little line here and a little line there. So those are the two ends. And then we're going to add a straight line that goes right up the middle. Next, we're going to work on what's going on behind our violin on this side of our picture. So we're just gonna actually just add some straight lines to the background to break up the background into some different sections so that when you're coloring it in, it looks a little bit more exciting. So I'm gonna start at this side of my paper and I'm gonna do a straight line all the way till it gets to the neck of my violin and stop. Then I'm gonna go down a little bit further and I'm gonna do another straight line starting at the edge of my paper. I'm gonna go till I hit my bow and then stop. Go to the other side and continue until you hit the bout of your violin. Now we have three different sections that we can play around with. And just for a little bit of extra details, I'm gonna add some different shapes into some of my sections, but not all. So I think up here, I'm gonna kind of copy the shapes that I see in the neck and in the little knobs right here, and I'm gonna just add some rectangles in this section. I'm gonna do another rectangle inside of that rectangle just to make it look super interesting. In this section, I think I'm gonna kind of follow along with this shape here and just add a big triangle. If you wanna add more triangles, you can. And then down here at the bottom, I think I'm just gonna add a little curved line right here in the corner, just so that that kind of goes with the shapes that I see in this section. If you wanna add any other shapes or lines or designs or whatever you think of to add, you can always add any extra details that you think of. All right, let's move over to the right side of our paper now. And this is where we're gonna get a little bit wild. And our violin is gonna start looking a little bit less like a violin. So let's add the body or the bout of the violin first. And I'm actually going to just make mine a rectangle. So I'm gonna start here at our middle line. I'm gonna go out and all the way down to the bottom of my paper. And so this half of the violin's body appears to be a rectangle. I'm gonna skip the neck for a minute because first I want to work on the little knobs that are at the top of the violin neck. And I'm gonna do mine a little bit crazy by making them just three bumps, keeping it abstract. Now let's add the neck. We can just start here where that last bump ends and just go straight down. So the neck of our violin is just a rectangle. And I'm gonna add three lines to this neck on this side, just so that it looks different than the neck on the other side. All right, now let's add some details to the bout of our violin on this side. The first thing that I wanna add is this little hole that you might see if you look at a picture of a violin. It's kind of shaped like an S, and it's actually a hole that goes into the violin, and the hole is to kind of capture the sound of the violin. It kind of echoes inside of the violin's body, and that's what makes the sound project. So it's kind of an S shape. I'm just going to draw an S shape right here, and I'm going to give it a little dot at the end and a little dot at the end, just to make it look a little bit more interesting. And then I'm going to add three lines for the strings. And they're just kind of, I just drew them over here where they fit. Time to add the background details on this side of our paper. And we're gonna do so by just doing some crisscrossing straight lines. So it doesn't really matter where you start your lines. I'm gonna start mine right here. I'm gonna start at the middle point and I'm just gonna draw a straight diagonal line all the way to the edge of my paper. Now I'm gonna start over here at the top of the body of my violin and I'm just gonna do another straight line that goes all the way to the top of my paper. I'm gonna start over here, straight line. I'm gonna start right here, diagonal straight line to the end. And now I think that's enough sections. I don't want to add too much because I don't want it to look too overstimulating on this side of our paper, especially since we have a lot of details on this side of our paper. All right, and we are all done our drawing part of this project. If you want to add any more details, you can go right ahead. But our next step after this is tracing. So go ahead and get out your marker or pen for tracing. All right, I'm done tracing. And then remember one more thing that you can do after you're done tracing, before you color, to make your drawing look a little bit neater, is just to go in with your eraser and erase out some of those pencil lines that you didn't trace over exactly perfectly while you were tracing. All right, and once you're done with that, it is time to color. One more thing. Broccoli wants to say hello, that he misses you guys, and you guys are doing a great job. He is so proud of you. All right, see you next time.